The government is saying, look, particularly on the migrant issue, for example, where the answer today has been given saying no such data is maintained. They say this data should be maintained by the states. Earlier, before you joined us, GVL Narasimha Rao said it's all very well to blame the center for gagging the opposition. In Bengal, how many days did you have a session just for one day? One day session, Kakoli goes Dastidar, the TMC had in Bengal. Who are you to take the moral high ground and target the Modi government?
He should be quite aware of the parliamentary system of proceedings. The Bengal session is a special session. This is a regular monsoon session. And in a regular session, the opposition has every right to question the government, to point out the follies. And
no, you haven't had a monsoon session in Bengal, ma'am. You haven't had a regular monsoon session in parliament. If I am a Bengali...
The demand for the state of affairs in the country and the falling economy of the country, the rising potato prices, the curtailment of the question hour, and also curtailment of individual time of the opposition and the government side members, they are impinging on the democratic right of the members.
So ma'am, you're saying, ma'am, Kakoli goes Dastidar, what you're saying about Delhi could be also held true of Calcutta.
Attention of media from this. Okay. They are trying to bring up topics which are irrelevant.
Okay. Let me move on to Manish Tiwari. Yes, Mr. Tiwari, you wanted to make a point because according to GVL Narasimha Rao, whether I raise this issue of why migrant workers' data is not provided or whether I raise the issue of a truncated questionnaire, he says this is making the government a punching bag, that the government of the day is being held responsible for whatever has gone wrong in the last 6 months, and the government cannot be, center alone cannot be held responsible. Questions should be asked to state governments on issues like migrants.
Rajdeep, unfortunately, my friend Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao seems to have run out of arguments, and that's why he's frothing at the mouth. If the NDA-BJP government had so much of faith in federalism, the first thing that the Prime Minister would not have done is announced a nationwide lockdown without consulting the states at a four-day notice. Let us go back to what the Prime Minister said. He says the Mahabharat war was won in 18 days. The war against COVID will be won in 21 days. But when they realized...
No, he said, sir, let me be fair. Let me be fair to Prime Minister Modi. He said, we hope to win this war in 21 days.
Well, all right, fine. I stand corrected. But when they realized that this entire lockdown is proving to be a complete failure, you had epidemiologists who morphed into economists and economists who morphed into epidemiologists. You know, latter could not flatten the curve, but the former flattened the economy. Then a very clever attempt was made to shift the blame onto the states. But the fact is that the government of India did nothing from the 30th of January till the 23rd of March, 30th of January 2020, when the first case was discovered in India,
okay.
and the 23rd of March, when the Janata curfew was put in place. And remember, when the Janata curfew was put in place, there were 381 cases in India with 7 deaths. There are over 45 lakh cases today, and many thousand people have died. Who is responsible for that? Is it not the responsibility of the opposition to hold the government accountable? If they want to hold the state governments accountable, yes, where they are in opposition or where they have a presence, they should hold those governments also accountable. But that does not in any case mitigate their responsibility or mitigate the responsibility of the opposition in order to hold the government of India responsible.